Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's Mark from Ford Mustang 98 Guy. It's another day in which to excel. Give me one sec. I'm in a really tight spot as I do this video. Well, it's another day in which to excel. I am here at my grandparents' house today, and I'm here to give you guys another update on the oldest car in my family. You guys know which car I'm talking about. Now, before I begin, I just want to say something real quick before I begin the video here. I'm just in the garage because I really don't have a lot of space to walk around the outside of the car. It has been such a busy summer for myself, for me, trying to get a lot of car reviews done. And throughout the summer, or throughout this time on YouTube, I've had a lot of people asking me to do an update on this thing here. I've had some people questioning me. You know, people say to me, "Hey Mark, you gonna do an update on your grandfather's Buick?" Well, guess what? I'm gonna tell you guys something right now. Nothing has changed with this car. As you see, we are now in September of 2023. The car still looks the same. Nothing has changed with this car. So it is another day in which to excel, and I'm going to give you guys an update for the month of September of 2023, this year. And I'm going to be doing another update once again on my grandfather's 2000 Buick Century. Now, nothing has changed with this car. It still runs good. Let me walk around the back. It does still run good. Most of the time it sits in the garage. So my grandfather bought this car brand new in July of 2000. And 23 years now, it has been now 23 years since he's had this car. It currently has 103,000 kilometers, which is still low mileage for this car. Let me tell you something right now. This car is well kept in the house. It's well kept. The rocker panels, if you look at the rockers, look at the rockers on this car. Solid. Look at the rockers. I've seen a lot of other Buick Centuries like this one. The rocker panels are just completely shot. Even underneath. Check out underneath there. I don't know if I'll be able to see it with myself, but if you take a look under the car, it's like, I don't know if you could tell, but it's like brand new. It's all black under there. Since day one, my grandfather had this car oil sprayed at Crown up until 2018, because he hasn't really been driving it much. There is a dent there on the fender that was probably there from before. That was probably a while back. The car is in great shape. It just needs to be cleaned. It's a little dirty on the inside. And the only blemish on the back of the taillight is right here. That happened many years ago. I mean, accidents happen, but as you see, this here is the oldest car in my family, besides my 2002 Buick Regal. This Buick, this Century here, my grandfather's Buick, is the oldest car in my family. So anybody who's new to my channel, any new viewers out there, not my longtime viewers, I'm talking about people who are new to my channel, have been just recently started watching my videos. This here is my grandparents' Buick Century. It is a 2000 model year. And believe it or not, this car is in really good shape for a 2000. Like, the body is just immaculate. There's no rust whatsoever. I know some people have been asking me about my grandfather's 2008 Silverado. He does still have that truck as well. He just doesn't get driven much. But I thought I'd show you guys the Century real quick, because I thought I'd make an update on it today, because it's just in incredible shape. I'm trying to get a good view here. There we go. The rims, look at the rims. Look at the rims right there.
Like brand new, shiny. Look pretty clean, it's just the car's not even washed. Look at that, rocker panels are solid. Rockers are just solid on this car.
Completely solid. Look at the back seat. Oh, I locked. I'll show the back in a second. I'll get to the back in a second, but real quick, before I get back to this, I know some people have been asking me about this vehicle here. This here is the 2008 Chevrolet Silverado. This is my grandfather's truck. Yeah, he still has it. Still looks like brand new. It's still the same. Nothing's really changed with it. It has less mileage than the Buick does, but usually my grandmother drives this and my grandfather usually drives this. He usually drives both. He's got this and he's got this here. My grandfather bought this truck in October of 2007. It's a 2008 model year. It was actually made in 2007. This is an early 2008 Silverado. This has also been in my family since brand new. I know some people have been wanting to see an update on this truck as well, but I'll be getting around to that maybe, well, not right away, because I'm not really too worried about it, and it just sits in the garage a lot. He doesn't really drive it much, so it mostly sits in the garage. He does start it here and there just to make sure the battery doesn't go dead, but you know, I've done some videos of it on it in the past. It still looks the same. It's just he doesn't drive it much. Mostly it sits here in the garage. So now getting back to the Buick, the Century, I'm going to take the key out of my pocket and I'll show you guys the interior before I start it up. I'm going to show you the key. There's the remote. Here are the keys. Show you guys the inside.
It just needs to be cleaned out. It's just got to be cleaned out. It's a little dirty on the inside. It smells like brand new when you sit in here. Look at that. Original floor mats.
This car is like brand new. The only thing is I'm not a fan of the color. I'm not a big fan of this color. My Buick Regal has more of that darker gray color. I'll show you the back. Yeah, it's a little dirty.
Look at the back.
I'll open the trunk real quick. You can either do it with the remote or I can do it with the key. Trunk is very spacious. I don't even know if my grandfather took it to Crown this year. Alright, so now, you know, the color of the exterior on this car is a drift sand metallic, which I call it baby shit beige. It's just a little joke that I've made, but it's more likely a light tan drift sand metallic color. And it's got cloth interior. It's beige tan cloth interior. It smells like brand new in this car. It's got 103,000 kilometers. I'm gonna go ahead and hop inside and I'll start it up. This is the Century, as you see. So I'm here doing another update for you guys. As you can see, the car is the same. Nothing's changed with it. One time, my grandmother did, what happened was, she was gonna go get her hair done, and she went out to start the car, and she couldn't get it started for some reason. I think there was something up with this key here. It's a pass key. Anyway, long story short, I think there was something up with the key. There was probably a security problem with one of the, this is a pass key they call it, but to be honest with you, I don't think there's anything wrong with this car. It's just, the thing is, my grandfather does not drive it much. He doesn't drive it. Like, he does drive it, but like not, he drives less. I mean, look at it. It still looks good, but it just needs to be cleaned. It's kind of dirty, dusty, especially on top of the dash. But I mean, this car is well kept. I mean, my grandfather takes care of it. He maintains it. He just hasn't cleaned it. He said he's gonna do it, and he just forgets to do it. And I don't know why on earth he still has not cleaned this car. It's still kind of dirty. I mean, I keep my Buick pretty clean. Like, you can see, look at that. Over the years, he hasn't even cleaned it. When was the last time he ever cleaned this car? Probably have to take it to a detailing shop. They have to probably do a proper detail on it, because it's pretty dirty. But overall, it runs. So I'm going to go ahead and take the key, and I will start it up and show you. This car runs really good. So I'm going to put the key in, and I'll start it up for you guys. This has the 3.1 liter V6, 3100. Oh, real quick, Jonah Mastro, this video's for you. I know you have a 2003 Buick Century. I thought I'd make this video for you. Here's the mileage, 103,575. Let's fire it up. Sweet. This car always runs good. You know, I had to get the coolant level sensor changed on my Buick Regal, and if you look on this one, oh, believe it or not, the light's not even on. Check that out. Because my grandfather told me the sensor, the coolant level sensor went on this one twice. And that's why he put this piece of tape on here a while back, because the light stayed on a lot. But now it's not even on anymore. Look at that. I'm gonna have to tell him that. Because he says the low coolant light always stays on, but it's a sensor issue. I had the same problem with mine as well. Anyway, I'm gonna review the inside. There is a little bit of a piston slap. I don't know if you guys can hear it. It's got a little bit of a piston slap when it's cold, because a lot of these 3.1s, they all have that piston slap. But yeah, car still runs good. Steering wheel is a little bit worn. I'll go through the gears. So you have here's your 4-speed automatic transmission, column mounted shift. Take the parking brake off. Low gear selection. And even shows up there as well. Sorry, sometimes my camera kind of goes in and out a little bit. Put the parking brake on. And the parking brake is foot operated.
See that?
It works. It's on. And then you have your gear selector, which is over here. It's like the Buick Regal, it's like my Regal, it just doesn't have a tachometer. Everything works. Everything is 100%. I see the low coolant light's not on. I don't know if you guys can tell. I'm gonna move the shifter out of the way. I wanna show you guys something. Look at that. Look right there. There's the light's not even on. I'm gonna have to tell my grandfather that. Anyway, I did change the cabin air filter last year. In May of 2022, I did change the cabin filter, so the air is much cleaner than before, and this seems to work okay. Low doesn't really, well, actually if you put it on there, it works, but low doesn't really work well anymore. I think there's a resistor problem with the fan blower. It's not, the blower works, see? It works, but I think there's a resistor problem, because if you put it on low, you just don't feel anything coming out. It acts like it's off, but it's not. See, it's low, but you don't feel nothing. Probably a resistor issue. Radio, cassette player only, no CD. My Buick has CD and tape player. This one just has tape.
Okay, hold on. You got to explain, what is a peaceful send off? Just walk us through that, what that would look like.
Yeah, for sure. So,
watch the volume here.
I've got two girls, they're 10 and 7, and I'm fortunate. They really love their school, their Beacon Christian School.
It's got the concert sound too system. Here you got your blinkers. And you got your wipers. Original wipers, by the way. Wipers are like brand new. So, I'm gonna hop out and I will show you guys the motor. I'll go through the rest of the interior in a little bit. Maybe I can show you real quick. This one has the manually dimming rearview mirror. I'll take this down for a second, just so I can show you the sun visor. My Buick has the same thing, just like this one. Slide out. I actually like that, because it gets the sun out of your face. And I gotta put this back. It's hard to do one hand. But give me one second, let me just put that back up. There we go. All right, then down here, you have your ashtray and cigarette lighter. You got your cup holders. And then over here is your storage. Here's your coin holder. My grandfather keeps this, my grandparents keep this on here. It protects it, I guess. They take good care of this car. They just haven't cleaned it in a long time. So I'll hop out and I'm gonna pop the hood and show you the motor. Actually, I'll turn on the headlights so you guys can see the headlights. Look at the headlights, like brand new. I'll show you guys the motor in one second. Look at that, like new. This car's super quiet. I gotta find it. I have to do it one hand. There you go, 3.1 liter, 3100 SFI, V6. I believe this is a aluminum block, or I think it's aluminum block, because I know the 3.1 multi-port is a iron block. This has, I think this is an aluminum block engine. The intake gasket was redone as well, because the intake gasket was leaking on this one as well. Actually, one time he did have the intake gasket done, but then it started to leak because they probably didn't put the proper gasket, so the dealership did the gasket. Now it doesn't leak. So just so you guys know, the 3100 is a good motor. It runs good though. You guys can hear it. It's got the same block as the 3400. Pretty much the same engine block. Here are the belts. Sounds good. Walk back so I can show you with the hood open. All right. Close the hood. Up over here so I can show you guys the side. Do the best I can here. Get the headlights on so you guys can see the lights. A little bit of smoke. The exhaust.
A little smoky.
It's a little smoky. Just a little bit of smoke coming out, but it's nothing serious. I'll sit on the passenger side. Passenger side. It's got the Century logo in the seat. This car needs to be cleaned up good. I mean, overall, it's in good shape. Original floor mats. It's got the Century logo on the mats. I wish my Regal was like that, but my Buick went through already three previous owners. I'm the fourth owner on my Regal. This was only one owner, which is my grandparents. They bought this brand new in 2000. The only thing that's a little bit on the floppy side with this car is the glove box. See, and you open it up. See, it's a little bit floppy. See it now, it doesn't close. It's a little bit loose, so I'm not gonna mess with it. I showed you in my previous video, there's something up with the glove box. I'm afraid to let it go because it's a little bit loose. So you have to kind of give it more effort to close it. I did put a Regal LS badge on my dash. See, this one says Century. If you saw the update video I did on my Buick, I did put a Regal LS badge on there. Because, you know, in 2002, some of the Buicks had it over here. It said, this one says Century, and then the Regal would say Regal. Mine didn't say it. It was just all black. Nothing was there. Getting a little warm in here. I'll get back on the other side in a second. Yeah, Buick made really good cars back then. This was junkyard replaced. You know, back then, Buicks were actually made good. Nowadays, GM doesn't make cars like they used to. So I'll sit in the back seat real quick.
seat in the back. Roll down the window a little bit just to get some air. This car just needs to be cleaned out a little bit. Two coat hooks in the back, it just doesn't have the grab handles. And then you have the ashtray right there. And it's a plain Jane Buick for the most part. Nothing's changed about this car. It still runs good. It's so solid. All right. I got the headlights on so you can see the gauges. They all light up green, just like my Regal. And the low coolant light's not even on, so that's good. That's a good sign. Here's the radio. Yeah, so that's that. Like I said, the car just needs to be cleaned a little bit. It's a little bit dirty. Cruise control is right here. Look at the lettering. It's still on there. On my Buick, it's a little bit worn out, but this one, you can still see the lettering. That's kind of amazing with this car. So I'm gonna roll up the window. There you have it. Let's shut her down. Shut off the lights. And there you have it. I mean, nothing's really changed with this car. It still runs like new. Thought I'd give you guys an update for September 2023. So, it does still run pretty good. There you have it. She looks good for being 23 years old. I don't want to run out of camera battery here run out of juice on my camera. So, I just hope that this car will continue to last and last. Because this is actually one of the cleanest Buick Sentries I've ever seen in my life. Because I've seen other Buick Sentries like this one on the road. Even when I'm out driving on the road, I've seen lots of these Buick Sentries around. There's honestly none of these around. You just can't find them in good shape. They're just so hard to find now. Let me tell you something right now. I don't think my grandfather will ever get rid of this car. I mean, he's going to hang on to it as long as he can. I mean, some people have been I had some tuber asking me about my grandfather. He's doing well. He's doing very well. And he's still healthy. Yes, he does still drive, even though he's in his mid-70s. But now, I want to come to the conclusion. Just want to take the time to say thank you for tuning in to today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed the update for the month of September 2023 on my grandfather's 2000 Buick Century. This is the Century 2000, just in case you're wondering. So this has aluminum rims right here. So those are aluminum wheels. That's why you see it says Century 2000. This is considered a Century Custom. But this one here is particularly a Millennium Edition for the year. So I think 2000, I think that's a Millennium Edition, I guess. Some sort of special edition. That's why they call it Century 2000. This car was probably worth $32,000 when it was brand new in 2000. But hey, 23 years later, here you go. Still running good. Now we come to the conclusion. Hope you guys enjoyed the update on my grandparents' 2000 Buick Century.
And now I just want to take the time to say thank you for tuning in. And this is Ford Mustang 98 Guy signing off. Thanks for watching and goodbye.